In other news, Philippine Senator Panfilo Lacson says he's willing to identify the government official he had accused of building troll farms all over the country. But he says he can only do so when his informant executes an affidavit.
Kinukumbinsi ko yung kinausap niya na mag-execute ng affidavit. Sa ngayon, hindi pa sa sumasagot. Oras na mag-execute ng affidavit yun, pwede kong banggitin ko sino.
Lacson earlier revealed a certain undersecretary has been using public funds to put up at least 2 troll farms in every province in the Philippines, hinting it could be used for next year's national elections. He says he learned about the scheme after the undersecretary asked for help on the project from one of Lacson's former employees. As the 2022 national elections near, media law experts caution the public against the resurgence of internet trolls. Attorney Mari Chulambino says social media users can help weaken the reach of troll farms by avoiding any interaction with them. She also encourages the public to report trolls to authorities.
I-block na natin sila. Huwag na natin silang engage. At kung makilala natin kung sino sila, maaari po nating isuklong sa NBI. At kung nagbabanta po, pinagbabantaan po tayo, isumbong po natin sa NBI pagkat yun po ay mga krimen.
For Dr. Rachel Khan of the University of the Philippines, it's high time for the Commission on Elections to be more strict in monitoring the social media expenses of candidates. That way, Khan says, COMELEC will know who among the candidates are utilizing trolls.
Siguro dapat yung kung nagmo-monitor sila talagang inuusisa nila yung expenses ng bawat kandidato. Yung mga vague na mga expenses dapat iusisa pa nila, di ba? Usually lalabas yan sa personnel, di ba? Bakit ganyan kadami yung hinire na tao? Sino sila? Ganon.
Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi wants a review of the National Grid Corporation's franchise, which he blames for last week's rotating power outages in Luzon. Cusi says the NGCP did not contract enough reserve power to fill an energy gap caused by 4 power plants going into unplanned shutdowns. But Philippine Senator Sherwin Gatchalian says Cusi himself can order the Energy Regulatory Commission to penalize the NGCP and other private power players.
If, for example, if they went on unplanned outage or forced outage, the consumers are the one bearing the economic losses. That should be transferred to the GenCo. So meaning they should be penalized. The last thing what we want to see is what we call regulatory capture, wherein the regulators already captured by the entities being regulated.
Meanwhile, power utility giant Meralco has announced it will raise electricity rates this month due to higher prices in the spot market. Meralco customers will see their June bills go up by 0.8 centavos per kilowatt hour. This translates to 16 peso increase for customers who consume 200 kilowatts per hour.